If you follow me, gonna enjoy me, no kill 'em all. Oh, kill 'em all.
Alrighty, guys, welcome back. So I'm starting on stretched hair. I'm just gonna do a part from ear to ear. And y'all, please pray for my bald spot. I accidentally cut off my hair one time when I was taking out crochet braids or something. So we're going to be doing two straight back braids in the front, and then everything else is going to be going diagonal from the middle two braids. So I'm just adding a bit of gel. I'm using Eco Style because it is not canceled for me. So I'm just doing a basic cornrow. You go under the middle. You know, I'm not even gonna try to explain. Just watch. Okay, so now we're just gonna do diagonal braids, going from the middle two braids. And yeah, I'm adding rubber bands to the end, but I'm gonna cut them off later. I just didn't want my braids to unravel. So yeah, if you're like me, I like when I'm doing my hair, I need some type of inspiration. I need to be watching a YouTube video or just watch the Good Wash Day. And that really helps with like making me want to do my hair, because to be honest, trying to figure out styles and stuff, doing styles with natural hair is tasking, like very, very tasking. Yeah, so I definitely suggest just playing my video in the background when you're doing your hair. It definitely will keep you motivated. So yeah, so this is all the braids. Yeah, that's cute. Okay, shoot, I was gonna wear it like this, to be honest. Okay, so now I'm gonna do the bantu knots. Yeah, so I do my bantu knots. Did I just say bantu knots? Girl, you're so African. But anyway, I do my bantu knots a little different. I braid my hair. One, just because I found that that gives me more definition, or like a more spirally fluffy curl. And I don't braid it all the way to the end either, because it just takes forever to unravel the braids when I do it that way. Oh, and I forgot to mention, the only product I'm using for this is Main Choices Pink Lemonade Mousse. And I would definitely recommend it for any type of roller set or bantu knot. The only thing I did notice is that it did flake a little bit, and it may have just been what I used to blow out my hair with. I don't know, but other than that, it did hold up my bantu knot out for a while, and it smells really, really good. So I'm just adding a little bit of gel to my end so it doesn't get too frizzy too fast. Okay, so now that we're all done, I'm just going to put a scarf on, and we are gonna wait till tomorrow to see how this turns out. Yep, my tomorrow dance. I don't know what down means. All right, so this is the next day. Okay, yeah, so I saw this at the beauty supply store. I was like, oh, let me get these for my edges so they can look kind of thick. And let me tell you, that was not cute. So, yeah, I was like, let me use my little happy edges. And I did still leave a little bit on there to so it could blend out, but I would not recommend just using it straight up. So I just put a little castor oil on my hands to reduce the frizz when I unravel. So I was definitely going for fullness and not definition. So I kept picking and picking and fluffing until I got my desired fullness. So I'm just adding a few hair accessories to spice it up, and that's about it. A few days later, I put this hair up in a puff, and everybody really liked that. But yeah, this is the finished look. It lasted me about a week, and I just slept with it in a pineapple and a bonnet. Make sure you like this video, subscribe, and leave me a comment of what you would like to see next. Bye.